Hi guys, we're back with another episode of Mundane Musings. In this episode, we continue our interview with Juhi and Ojaswi, where they will discuss an introspective way of life, where you ask questions in order to make better decisions, some thoughts on the mentorship program, and the most amazing thing, the new streams at IIITD, that is ITSS and CSD.
So coming back, he talked about what is life, right? Mm. So I would advise not just questioning what is life, but questioning everything you do to some level. Like not just going to deep, kya kar rahi hu main. No, just like your decisions, just question them once before you make them. Like you want to take corsets, why? Because I like it. Why do you like it? Because my friend is taking it. So why are you taking it? You know. Like that way, sometimes you end up taking courses just because your friends are taking it or just because you hear that there's an easy faculty member who will be like, you know, like this with the grades and you're going, but no, I mean, you should take courses that genuinely interest you. A lot of people, I think I talked about this before as well, a lot of people think that okay, easy courses will be good, our placement will be good, you know, CV will be good. I don't think that's a very good habit.
हाँ बट आई मीन प्रायोरिटीज की बात है समवन हु इज हैप्पी विद अ विद अ वेरी नॉर्मल लाइफ वी आर नो वन टू जज व्हाट दे वांट इन लाइफ राइट सो ठीक है
यार एग्जैक्टली इट्स जस्ट एडवाइस
समवन वांट्स अ डीसेंट जॉब एंड दे नो दैट दिस इज द पार्ट टू इट एंड दे वांट टू डू इट इन फाइन
Yeah, but then even with a decent job, if you have a really good CGPA, but you don't have the knowledge you required behind the job, I mean, it's pointless.
But yeah, so from a societal point of view, what you're doing is that you're just following the others.
Yeah.
Mm.
So the society doesn't go forward. Mm. But when you read about people like Elon Musk, or, you know, the giants, then you get to know what were they up to in their undergrad years. And what is that you should do? I mean, it's good to idolize people, not pedestalize in the sense ki bahut mahaan hai, but if you want to be like them, if you want to make a change, if you want to go forward, then you should read about these people and look into what they were up to while they were doing these things. There are a lot of autobiographies and biographies which are good enough. So, what is the point I'm making? Yeah. So it's okay if you just want a job, that's okay. But there will be people who want to rise above the ordinary. So for them, it's important to explore a lot, to ask the right kind of questions. How, what, when, why? Why is probably the most important question. As I said, intelligence is about understanding what you're doing. So asking why is very important. And what we're learning in engineering and what science is about is how. Like how life works. We don't ask why is there life? That is a philosophical question. So that you can discuss with Professor Raj here.
Yeah, I would actually recommend everyone take at least one course of Professor a year because his courses encourage you to think beyond the ways that you could have thought possible. Like I took this course in my first year CT and at that time I didn't understand it quite well, but when I was a PA for him last semester, I actually could appreciate all the different directions he's taking you in. He introduces so many concepts to you that if you really think about it, you know, your mind will open like to different horizons.
It's mainly about breaking assumptions.
Yeah.
When you think about, you know, you're assuming that you're not living in a simulation, but what if you are? Right, then you start thinking something else. So you break assumptions and then you think more about it. What could it possibly mean? And people should take HSS courses very seriously, I think. Because people take HSS courses as, you know, something additional.
Just for the credits.
But you have to do 12 credits. I mean, I was the happiest person. I actually almost jumped and came back home. I mean, I was jumping and coming back. I didn't come in a single jump.
Thanks for clearing that up.
Is that called jump running or whatever? Okay. Running with jumping?
Running with a skipping master.
Okay. So, and this was because this was my last social sciences paper, 10th ka paper khatam, 11th science padunga main. What really interests me.
Yeah.
And I had this sort of the same approach, and I was like, yeah, humanities ke courses, not my thing.
Nahin, but
and
these aren't
now,
actually
yeah.
humanities courses.
I mean, schools were very different.
Yeah,
very
don't be
important
guilty
to,
about dropping courses.
Yeah,
that's
learn
what
to move on,
yeah.
learn to make mistakes and be happy about it and really learn to let go.
Achha, वैसे how does that look on? So, I'm personally I'm very worried about कि अगर कोई course ले लिया है तो drop करेंगे, that appears
it
on your transcript.
It just appears as a W, as a withdrawn.
Yeah.
That's it.
So, like, how does that affect people who look at your transcript?
Now.
I don't know.
It doesn't affect that much. See, I had a late drop as well, and I got a job. And I've been accepted in the master's. Not to brag, you know, but
it's
on
a good
my
decision.
List.
It's a good decision to take a late drop rather
yeah.
than an F, because
no,
it
actually
saves
a D
you,
is worse than an F.
Yeah, it saves you half a semester of effort, because right up the midsem, you can drop the course. Also, it does not make a big difference. In the long run, logo CGPA aaj nahi rehta. ट्रांसक्रिप्ट के अंदर 50 कोर्सेज में एक कोर्स को ड्रॉप किया था ये तो मतलब तुम खुद भी भूल जाओगे दुनिया भूल जाएगी डोंट केयर ठीक है आई मीन दिस इज बेसिकली एकेडेमिया के अंदर की करेंसी है ठीक है रियल वर्ल्ड में मैटर भी नहीं करता है
Okay. Achha, I have a question for you. So you are on the mentor review board, right?
Yeah.
So can you talk about ki, what is the ideology behind the mentorship program? And
also will we get mentors in 2nd, 3rd and 4th year? 4th year to milega.
Okay, so in the mentorship program, they're starting to expand it now. It's going to go to MTechs and definitely anyone at any stage, in fact our professors need some kind of counseling, mentoring. So,
yeah, I've actually heard stories about that. They do go for mentoring.
Yeah, so the main point of mentoring, actually it was asked in the last mentor meeting and I replied, hey. It was right. Many others replied.
So proud.
Thank you. Yaar, achievements to kuch hai nahi meri. Kabhi koi din aaye jo main thoda proud hoke bol paun. I mean, the last time I did this was in class 12.
So, the juniors who come in, unka linear algebra. Then they realize you have taken advanced linear algebra. That's
oh my god, seriously, when I heard he's taking advanced linear algebra, I'm like, what is wrong with you?
What is wrong with you? We didn't even know what's in the course.
Yeah, my definition of being a mentor, which was accepted, is that a mentor helps the mentee see beyond what it can see right now. So like, if you only see these many options, like this is what I'm limited to, and then the mentor's job is to explain to this person that you have these options to broaden your perspective, and then a mentor can only do that much. I mean, it can't possibly force that person into taking some action which is safe or right according to the mentor. It's only to show them the right, not even showing the right path, just showing them the options, that you have all of these options. It's not only restricted to what you're thinking right now. For example, if you get into some situation, like something like plagiarism, so you get so engrossed in it, you start thinking, you know, course ka grade kharab ho jayega, CGPA kharab ho jayega, job nahi lagegi, tum itna zara social lag jata. So the mentor's job is to help them to come out of that phase and think of it in a more broad way, ki how much does this really affect my CGPA, how much does it really affect things in the long term. So helping them in taking the right decision for them, what in understanding what the right decisions are, that is sort of the basic idea. And the other thing is to help them transition in this 1 year phase when they come into the culture of triple IDT and then they get this culture shock. Sabko different. There are some people who are who can't converse very well in English. So they find it really difficult. So किसी को इंग्लिश आती भी है उसके बाद भी लाइक उनका दिमाग खराब हो जाता है पीपल हु डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द लैंग्वेज इट्स अनदर level, it's in another hurdle. But there are people who have conquered that because they wanted to. And then as mentors, we try to help people in going over the language barrier. So there are a lot of issues, like every mentee is going to have a very different issue. Mm-hmm. Like sab log bahut different hote hain. So we have to tailor make our advices. We have to listen to them for very long. It's almost like doing anthropology. You have to understand everything, and before giving an advice, you really have to understand what the problem really is. In fact, in the initial phase, they'll not even tell you what the real problem is. So rapport building or something, it's very good for the mentor. You get to learn a lot of things. Eventually, if you keep participating in extracurricular activities, your speaking skills improve, your ideas improve, you basically your personality improves, and not just for doing an MBA. I don't want to do an MBA, but I think just to lead a more fulfilling life.
And you bond more with other people.
Yeah.
Yeah,
so I'll add a few things here. So he talked about a mentor who shows different perspectives and helps to guide the mentee. That is one part of it, but there's another part where, you know, the mentor just listens. That is very important too. Someone who can just listen to you and, you know, be there for you whenever you want. So that is also one of the very important roles of a mentor, because to know that there is someone who will stand behind you, someone who is there for you at all times, no matter what happens, that is a very powerful feeling. And when the two of us were in our first year, we didn't have any mentorship program. So I don't know about you, but I used to feel isolated at times.
Yeah.
In my first year, I used to be like, kya kar rahi hu main yahan pe koi bhi nahi hai.
Physically isolated, I just used to stay in my room.
Yeah, see, exactly. See, no mentor.
They could be
so traumatized.
But this is actually happening with me right now. My mentor will go away after this year. So I'm like, ab kya hoga?
Yeah, so then you look for more seniors. See, that's the thing. A mentor has been assigned to you in the first year because you don't know anyone. But now, through the mentor, you might have known a few people. Maybe essay out to seek a time. Yeah, if you're in some club, you interact with a few seniors. So to talk to them, get to know them, through them get to know more people. That is how you sort of start connecting with people, and you realize, okay, this person is an okay person to talk to, but probably not a very good mentor. You know, this person can be a good mentor for this particular thing. This person can be a good mentor. So one mentor cannot satisfy your mentoring
requirements
for everything, right? I mean, you need mentoring for academics, you need mentoring for personal life, you need mentoring for running, I don't know. So you need different mentors for that. You need different mentors for different things. If you think you can just find one person who satisfies all of these criteria, you are delusional. To say it in very harsh words.
Achha, so there are these new streams being introduced. Design and ITSS, and jab ITSS introduced hua, we were saying, shit, this shit is awesome, we'll have a whole batch of Steve Jobs.
Yeah, see, they're gonna get people from humanities, yeah, that is so cool.
Exactly.
So, any thoughts about that? People coming into those streams, what?
Well, Prof Ayer is really excited about it. He's like, yay, you know, ITSS IT center ban raha hai, HSS ko importance milega.
हमें तो वॉल देख के ही समझ आता है फेसबुक पे दिस गाय इज एक्साइटेड
या
यू सी दिस बिग फेसबुक पोस्ट हाउ मच टाइम डू यू हैव
सो आई थिंक ही कैन टॉक मोर अबाउट डिजाइन आई विल टॉक अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट आईटी सोसाइटीज
नहीं बट द फैक्ट दैट दीस सच प्रोग्राम्स आर बीइंग इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इटसेल्फ इज रेडिकल
हां
आई हैव नॉट सीन
इट इज या इट इज एक्चुअली सैड दैट वी डोंट हैव दोस प्रोग्राम्स ऑल ओवर द कंट्री वी हैव वेरी रिजिड आई मीन 17 साल पहले क्या होता था दैट वी हैव सिविल एंड वी हैव दिस डिफेंस राइट आई मीन इट्स लाइक थिंग्स व्हिच आर फॉर सिविलियंस एंड थिंग्स व्हिच आर फॉर डिफेंस राइट सो दो ही ब्रांचेस होती है समथिंग ऐसा कुछ होता था मैकेनिकल सिविल सिखाते थे ये सब पढ़ाते थे इसके अलावा कुछ भी नहीं था ठीक है तो अब सब कुछ इतना डाइवर्सिफाई हो चुका है आई मीन वी आर इन सच अ स्टेज वेयर दीज थिंग्स आर वेरी रेलेवेंट टू डू राइट नाउ So, IT and society, so as a CSE student, you get to know what's going inside a system. as an EC student also, but at a more physical level or whatever, like levels you can choose. CSE mein you are more in a higher level, higher not like, you know, higher pay, higher in the sense you're looking from a bird's eye view and you're using things and building systems. As an EC student, you are on a more lower level, but it's very imperative to the working of the whole system. As an IT and society student, I think you will be taking that entire system, that IT, and applying it to the society, to real world problems. And these 4 years, you will be trained through various courses to understand both things first, ki IT kya hai, humanities kya hai, and then in the last 2 years, you will end up doing courses where you'll do projects, where you'll apply IT to society, or society to IT too, like HCI or digital anthropology. You're applying societal concepts to make better apps or something like that, right? So we right now have excellent HSS courses, excellent faculty members in HSS. So I think it was a very valid decision to make this new packaging where you can do best of both worlds in these two areas.
Yeah, and they're recruiting more faculty members for these two degrees as well.
Yeah, and maybe you, I mean, after that you might not get a very conventional job that you want. You can totally, but you will be enabled to do something which is very relevant to the society right now. You will end up probably working for an NGO, or you'll go, you know, as a lone wolf making some app, or you join some society, some people of mutual interest, or you go and work for some corporation.
You can even go it's for awesome. US design after IT society.
And I was also thinking ki like jo leaders hote hain, those who manage projects and MBA
people.
Because I just realized this, that so we had this Camp Tickets medical hackathon, right, in college.
Yeah, yeah.
And so we designed, our group designed a medical ATM, health ATM, so that you can walk in and like all your stats are measured and you just walk away.
That'll come into active society.
But the thing is, this was the best question asked by a judge to us, and we, like, all of our night went into thinking that up. That, so there are a lot of informal health workers in the society right now, right? So pharmacist, compounder, koi bhi hai, and people go there, 50 rupees rakhte hain, they take a prosin and go away. So what would motivate them to walk into your health ATM? Jab unka 50 rupees mein kaam ho raha hai, they are ready to give away money, right? What is the motivation behind it?
And this was the roadblock for us, because we couldn't think about how, like, it was very tough for us to think about people, but it was very easy for us to think about sensors and jo bhi system.
Exactly.
Banana.
So the thing here is, you don't have the whole holistic view here.
Yeah.
Like, so that is what IT society, even HSS courses in general, that is what they encourage you to do, to make your mind such that you have a holistic view, or at least you can think holistically. So, one more point I'd like to add, I don't know down the future how it will be, but abhi tak toh IIIT is a very open college. Like, if you want to do something from a stream that you're not a part of, you can do it. It won't be very easy, but you can still do it. Like, agar mujhe kuch robotics mein karna hai, jo core ECE ka hai, I can still do it. I can talk to faculty members, I can probably sit in a few courses, I might not get the grade for it, but you know, I can learn about it, I can do it. So, looking at the past trend, I am hypothesizing that future may be aisa hi hone wala hai. So, even with IT society, if you get into it and then you realize that I'm more interested in the IT part, maybe it is possible that you get to concentrate more on IT than on society. And the other way around too, you come into CSE, you realize that yeah, mujhe, you know, society mein bhi kaafi achha lag raha hai. So maybe you can diversify, maybe they introduce a minor in society. You don't know. I mean, the best part is IIIT is now a part of this evolving world where finally India is now growing and they are introducing new degrees. Jaise America mein bahut common hai, you know, you major in something, you minor in something, you do a double major in something. And so far India mein ye nahi hua hai.
And most CEOs in the US are people from liberal arts background, whereas in India they're all tech CEOs.
Exactly. So, and you can see the difference.
Haan, exactly.
You
quality
mein
bahut difference aata hai. The way a company treats you.
So like IIIT, that way I really love the fact that they're introducing these new degree programs. And I would love to see in the future that they give more freedom for students to actually, you know, shift between the degree programs to some extent.
So about the IT and
design,
computer science and design,
yeah,
IT and design,
computer science
design
and
media
design. Okay, so I mean, I was trying to make an animation last week, and I just could not do it. Making an animation is really difficult. To make an animation which someone will accept, like a guy walking, just to make a guy walking, first of all to make the guy, that cartoon which looks acceptable, then to break it down into these portions which are going to move, and then to make the whole motion smooth, that it looks like that the guy is walking to a certain degree, it's very difficult to achieve. There are tools which have steep learning curves and so on. So when you ask these kind of questions, that how do you go about doing things, and then you're like, yeah, laptop pe ho jayega. But as a BTech student, what you get to know is ki laptop ke andar kaise wo banana hai software. So design is a very vast topic. I mean, one motivation is that you watch some animated movie. Okay, usme dekh ke lagta hai sab kuch itna fluid hai, it's almost like the real world. 10 saal pehle possible nahi tha, 10 saal ke pehle ke games ka bilkul crap hota tha. IT and design, it's very relevant, by the way, because right. So, हम लोग हमारे बहुत सारे games, जैसे games हम लोग क्या foreign जितने भी studios होते हैं उनके games खेलते हैं. India में कितने ही animation studios हैं. Indian games ही कितने हैं. हमारे यहाँ वो culture ही नहीं है. तो ये अब develop हो सकते हैं इसके through. तो and we have good faculty members. We have people who work in computer graphics. So computer graphics is a very computer science thing. It's about writing, rendering softwares and these softwares in which you can do this animation and so on, algorithms about that. So you will be taught about the computer science aspect of it and then the design aspect of it. I don't know, I'm just guessing ki ye sab hoga. And the design aspect of it, ki what all, from a user's point of view, how do you use these stuff? How do you make it more user friendly probably? What features do you want to put in? You ask those kind of questions. Keep a designer ke liye kya acha hoga, and then maybe ek engineer ke point of view se kaise aur efficient banaya jaye us computation ko. You'll get to learn both of these things. So I think these new programs are personally I find them very more interesting than just doing CSE.
Yeah,
it's really cool.
And I guess we already talked about HCI, that could also be one of the career paths.
Exactly. Also, could you tell us more about PreCog? What is PreCog?
PreCog is a research group here, one of the many research groups. It's headed by Professor PK and his PhD students, whom he calls pillars. That's really cool, you know, because they're the pillars that hold up the structure. So usually, if you want to get into PreCog, you apply online and they conduct interviews, they take coding tests and stuff, and if you pass everything and they like you, you get it. for me, it was a little different. I took the DHCS course and
DHCS?
Design a Human-Centered Systems. Last year I took that course, and that's when I was like, you know, HCI. So then, I was performing really well in the course, so PK came to me and he asked if, you know, I would want to work with him in the summer. I said, yeah, okay, you know, I'll think about it a little bit. Because at that time, I was still not sure about HCI as a field for me. I just thought, ki theek hai, you know, kuch toh hoga. Then I got an internship at some place and I started working there as well, and then I talked to PK again. I said, like, you know, is it okay if, you know, I can work with you during the summer? Because that by then I was like, you know, ye internship nahi karni mujhe, mujhe HCI mein karna hai kaam. And he's like, cool, aa jao, you know, internship ka hai khula. So that is how I joined PreCog. I went there as an intern. I interned there for the summer, and the next semester I took a BTP with PK for 4 credits, and now I'm doing it for 8 credits. My life is awesome. But yeah, it just depends on that one lucky break that you get, you know. You talk to the right person and you knock on the right door at the right moment and it opens up. you grab that opportunity and you run. Because that doesn't happen all the time.
But you don't keep running behind opportunities.
You just have to
keep in mind two things in academics that Raj sir told me. That you have to be regular and you have to show up every time. Mm. Right? You have to be regular and you have to be serious about it. And then things will just fall in place. You will keep getting opportunities because people are looking for people who can work for them and do good stuff. If you are regular and you're serious about something, you can pretty much do anything.
Yeah, but then it doesn't always... Yeah, that is true, you can do anything, but it also depends on the opportunities you get. You don't always get the same opportunities again and again. If I had said no to PK at that time, in that summer, I wouldn't have gotten that... I wouldn't have gotten that opportunity again. I would never have explored FCI as an option or even as a specialization. See, he's the only one here who's doing work that is close enough to what I'm interested in. User evaluation and, you know, FCI, that particular component, the user side, the social side. And now we have another faculty member. I'm working with him. Professor Shiram and with PK, both of them. So, this semester I'm really enjoying my work because that is actually what I'm interested in. Last semester it was thoda bahut, it's cool. But this semester, yay! So, it just depends on grabbing the right opportunity at the right moment. If you miss it, fine. Like you said, it will come again, but it might not. So, why waste it? Plus, internships help a lot here. So, in my second year, I interned at a corporate place where I was developing. I was in a developer position and I realized I hated it. Mm-hmm. I did not like developing. I did not like the whole corporate setup. Mm-hmm. I felt suffocated there. So, that is when I realized that developing to mujhse nahi hone wala. Corporate to chodo. So, exactly. I mean, these 4 years are when you experiment a lot and when you actually realize what works for you and what doesn't. Of course, over the course of a few years, your interest might change again. You might realize ki nahi mujhe corporate mein jana hai, acha lag raha hai mujhe. But abhi ke liye, like for the next 5 years, you will know in these 4 years what you want to do. So experiment.
You don't do research for the sake of doing research.
Haan.
You don't do an internship for the sake of doing an internship.
Exactly.
You do something that you're interested in.
See, first year ka summer I think is best utilized for CWS.
Yeah.
It is the best. It is the ideal time because then baad mein you get a lot of courses, you get a lot of projects. Internships hoti hai yaar, kab karoge CWS? But end mein, there are a lot of
people. Not just for getting the credits of CWS, because doing CWS seriously will be probably the greatest impact of your education on you. Because isse pehle to life, now you'll do CW, you'll have an increased amount of sensitivity towards the society. Tumhe pata chalega issues kya hote hain. SG karoge, you will discover some talent within.
CW you should do in a place where actually you will learn something. There are a lot of my friends who are just doing CW for the heck of it.
Yeah.
That is not a very good approach.
It's a waste of your 2 credits.
Seriously.
Yeah, I wasted my CW credits throwing surveys here and there. In fact, second year I got motivated to do community work. So I worked for a year as a web developer for one NGO. I made their website and so on. So अच्छा लगा उनके volunteers से मिलके उनके organisation को देखकर कि जो लोग और भी काम करते हैं, they're trying to help some low socioeconomic groups in the society, and it's a very rewarding experience to do these things.
Yeah, I remember. Plus, for the people who are actually interested in building a good CV, your CW helps a lot. Because अगर आप job के लिए जा रहे हो, तो they will take note of this. अगर आप MS के लिए जा रहे हो, they will definitely take a note of this. MS में they don't just see academics, they also see your extracurricular activities. CW counts, hobbies count, club mein participation counts, your community that all counts.